Let me start this way by saying thank you to the Starts family. You guys really know how to put on a clam bake. Daniel and Christian Starts, beautiful, beautiful night. Thank you very much. Could I get a round of applause for Daniel and Christian Starts? So my name's Nick Karnos, otherwise known as Peekow, sometimes known as Biggun. I am the father of the groom, proud father of Hayden Karnos, and arguably the guy who might be gaining some of the most today by gaining Lauren Karnos as my daughter-in-law. So what I wanted to do, seems as though we're fairly close to University of Texas, where they're changing the world, I thought I would offer a series of if-then statements to kind of summarize part of how I feel tonight and part of what I wanted to pass along to Hayden and Lauren. An if-then statement, just for those of you who might not know, it's a fairly academic thing. It's usually used in computer programming or math. I'll give you an example of one. If X plus 2 equals 3, then X equals 1. So, if-then statement. To the Starts family, if Hayden provides you with just a mere fraction of the laughs and entertainment that he's provided to us for the last 25 years, then you will be entertained for the rest of your lives. I promise you that. For Buddy, if your marriage gives you the memories that mine has, then you will have led a charmed life. I lead a charmed life. Those of you who know me know that I'm a professional family man, a transportation hobbyist, a aspiring trout bum, and a future star for the senior PGA. Lauren, if you are half as understanding and tolerant as Mary Frances has been, then Hayden may be the luckiest man on the planet today. I know in the case of our house, Mary Frances has put up with more juvenile, delinquent jokes and immature body sounds than she has deserved, and she's done it the whole way through laughter. Thank you, Mary Frances, for 27 years of wedded bliss. So, I also, if this is the end of kind of the boys club and players lounge, then my roommate, Mary Frances, is very, very excited. If this wedding means kind of the end of your family nucleus as you know it, then Lauren, I promise you, and I know you've gotten a taste of it, then you can look forward to a new family beginning with all of these people that have come down from British Columbia, Washington, Colorado, Oregon, the Rogers side of the family, and Joe Rogers is here, is an extraordinary, extraordinary group of people that have provided us with more laughs and more love and more family for the last 27 years than I could possibly have imagined. So Lauren, that is actually kind of a gift to you, is this whole family crew is phenomenal. I know you already know that. So if parents are role models for their kids, then I hoped we have served you well. But sometimes I need to offer the converse of that. Sometimes you can learn more by things that your parents didn't do than the things that they did. I know that's been the case with me. I was brought up in a non-traditional family household, and I probably learned more about what not to do than how to do things properly, and it served me well to this day. And I hope Hayden and Lauren, you guys both keep that in mind as you move forward. Lauren, if there are expectations that Hayden will mentally or socially mature beyond age 13, then I am anticipating extraordinary disappointment. I'll give you just a real simple example of that. There are certain words that may be said in casual or even formal conversation, or at random, or in public places, or wherever, that are probably going to generate some snickers, generate some looks, maybe even generate all-out laughter. I'll give you just a short sampling of those words. Buddy, if you could do your best to keep a straight face, I'd appreciate it. Poop, buns, boobs, mucus, spittle, crop dusted, dust cropped, sack, crack, groinards, and 69. Lauren, I wish you the best of luck in putting up with that. It never seems to get old. And I think as long as you laugh, I think you'll be okay. Last one. If dads are allowed to declare their sons as personal heroes, then this is my public declaration. Hayden has been one of my heroes for most of his life. I've watched him work through adversity, and I've watched him work through certain defeat, absolute certain defeat, where he knows the outcome is not going to be favorable to him. But he works through it, he goes through the motions, and at the end of it, gives a characteristic shrug like only Hayden can do, dusts himself off, and moves on. And those are attributes that are very rare, and I've never had them. In the face of certain defeat, I'm more likely the guy that's probably gonna try to figure out a different way to do it or skip it altogether. But if dads are allowed to declare their sons as personal heroes, this is my public declaration. Hayden has been one of my heroes for almost his entire life. So he is part of our gift to the Starts family. Hayden represents what is best in all of us in this cynical world full of skeptics like myself. Hayden maintains a faith in basic humanity, a faith in human nature that gets him through every day without the cynicism and skepticism that is so ever present in most of our lives. Sorry, this is actually the last one. Please charge your glasses. If this is a milestone life event, then raise your glasses and toast my son and brand new daughter-in-law, Lauren Karnos. Success, family, laughter, and love.
Wise men say, only fools pressure. Well, but I am falling in love with you. Shall I say, would it be a sin if I falling in love with you? Like a river flows surely to the sea, darling, so it goes. Some things are meant to be.